with things.
To negotiate with me? Is that how it is?
I'm joking.
I know why you're here. You want to know how I'll treat the Redwoods going forward. Now that I've taken back what's rightfully mine, I have no interest in shouldering your grudges against the Reavers. Don't bother me, and I won't bother you. We'll each take care of our own.
How's Rob?
Rob? You don't need to worry about him. There's no way he'll betray me again. Ever. You want to see him? Sure. He's just next door. Here, give him this. I think his daughter Martha painted it. He'd be happy to see it.
Is this Martha's painting? Oh, Martha. My little girl. It's over, Rob. Your wife and daughter are gone. Let go of the hate. Let go of the hate. You believe everything she fed you, didn't you? You know who she really is. You know what she's capable of. Don't let me ignore her just because she agreed to work with you. Just wait and see how the Reavers, Redwood Force will only get worse. Tell her that whatever she does, do not let me out. Because I will not stop until she's in a worse place than I am now.
Oh, did he really say that? I guess he's trying to get between you and me. Don't let him get to you.
What are you going to do with him?
Mind your own business, kid. He's mine now, and I'll do whatever the hell I want with him. Run along to your little Redwoods now, and don't come back unless it's urgent. Remember, you killed a lot of Reavers, and I'm the boss of the Reavers.
Elisia leads the Reavers now? I guess things are about to change around here. If we're technically still her allies, we should stay away from clashing with them. If what you said is true, then there's a lot more to her than meets the eye. That means she's very dangerous. Possibly even more dangerous than Rob. Don't get into it with them. This land has seen too much already. We don't need hotheads running around causing a ruckus. We need to settle down and focus on making a better life. Thanks for all your hard work. With the Reavers out of our hair, we have a lot to do. I'd like you to stay and help out.
The last car is loaded and ready to go.
You came right on time, Vulture. Thanks to you, we were able to minimize our losses and...
I didn't think I'd see the day that Viperia Bonnie made a misstep.
Rob, that fool. I misjudged him. It's true.
I heard it was the new shelter that got in the way and made this mess.
Raven's shelter. Looks like we won't be able to avoid dealing with them in the future.
You're back! It's all thanks to you that Redwood Outpost was able to survive this crisis. Is everything okay with Nelson?
Nelson is on his way here. I think he and Caine want to iron out the details about the alliance between Redwood Outpost and the Ravens.
What we've achieved with Redwood Outpost is all because of you.
Don't mention it. I only did what I thought was right.
Caine believes that you've passed all the tests to become a core member of the Raven Squad. It's time that you learn more about the innermost workings and secrets of the shelter.
Secrets?
That's right. From now on, you're really one of us. Come with me, and it'll all become clear. This is the Raven's secret base.
Secret base?
Yep. You'll see once you're inside. Not everyone gets to come in here, you know. Raven's secret base. This is a space set up especially for elites. Here, there are different areas with different functions. Have a walk around compared with the danger-riddled surface. This is the perfect place to relax. Not even seasoned warriors can handle long periods of stress.
Hey, won't you win Satan? Just treat this place like a garage full of diesel fumes. You're gonna love it.
Roman, this place is way better than a garage.
Yeah, yeah, whatever Sherry says. I can't believe you're here. I guess that means you want a bus now.
Hey, Roman, great to see you. How's your...
I'm all better now, thank you. In fact, I've never felt better in my life. I've had enough of lying in bed. I practically have mushrooms growing on me.
I totally understand what you mean. To live is to move.
Speaking of mushrooms, you have to try this mushroom soup here at underground base. They started making my range recipe. They shared tweets because there were a couple spices that they couldn't get a hold of. Now, every Wednesday evening.
All right, Roman. Let's not keep standing at the door on our first visit to the base. Let's head over to the sofa.
Of course. Of course, of course. Unfortunately, there's no one here except Captain at the moment. She's probably in Arsenal working on new shipment weapons that just came in. As for Tang.
No one knows where he is. How about getting us a clue here next time? Like...
Hey, look who's here. It's the hero of the Redwood Outpost. Captain, have you seen this one you get?
Oh?
Ha! Looks like someone's got competition.
Interesting. I'd like to see this for myself. You're here because the Raven Squad has recognized your abilities and your character. From now on, you're one of us. Welcome to our base. I'm in charge of the arsenal here.
The arsenal?
Even the best warrior needs quality equipment to help them out. If you ever need any, you can...
All right, Captain. That's enough about the equipment. The day's a rest day after all. Why isn't Tank here anyway? Isn't he always here training whenever he has some free time?
He's right behind you.
Tank, what did you do here?
I've been here the whole time.
Are you sure you're not a ninja?
How about giving us a clue here next time? Like making some noise, maybe? That's Tank for you. At the door you met.
Of course. Great to see you again, Tank.
You have what it takes to be a great warrior. Just keep training.
But the day's a rest day.
What Tank means to say is, you can drop by any time to train with him. We have all sorts of facilities here at the base just for that. So we're here a lot whenever we're not on a mission.
Of course. It feels just like home here.
Do you remember when the two of us went to help Redwood Outpost? That look of disbelief on Nelson, it was too dangerous to go with just two people. Thank goodness you made-
I say defend Redwood Outpost in the president itself, but saving a tech whiz like me? That's a real contribution.
Hey, tech whiz. Wanna help me carry things for 10 kilometers?
Better go back to the clown's head.
Looks like everyone's seen what the rookie's made of.
Of course. Already got the Raven spirit, that one.
Our new comrade has been sheltered for some time now. By now, we've seen how brave and resourceful rookie can help us fight off the enemy, help facilitate alliance. Therefore, I think I speak for everyone in the Raven. Welcome to our ranks. Our friends from Redwood Outpost will be here soon. Sherry, you'll be joining us for the meeting since you're part of the mission.
Sure thing, Caine. I really have to catalog that new batch of equipment that just came in. I'll head over to the arsenal first.
Then Roman.
I got time, eh?
But Roman hasn't fully recovered yet. In fact, he's supposed to be in bed right now, but he's snuck out to see. It might be better if...
Hey, whatever happened to keeping Elisia? Whatever happened to trust the Raven Squad, huh?
All right, Roman. Since Dr. Michael and Sherry both think you should take some more time off, you should go back to bed. That's an order.
Back to Roman Mushroom's
ideas. Tang, I think you should speak to Nelson about the defense plan for Redwood Forest.
Yeah.
Come on, let's head over to the meeting room. Let us welcome Nelson, who's attending this meeting on behalf of the zombies, reavers, and all kinds of other challenges awaits. None of us can make it far if we're isolated alone.
Thank you, Ravens. For saving the Redwoods time again from the reforming alliance with the Ravens was the right thing to do. I'm confident now that I've not let the Redwoods down.
You're a wise leader, Nelson.
Caine, the Redwood Outpost Wood and Labor Force are yours if you need them. Just say the word.
Thank you, Nelson. Just hearing your offer is plenty enough.
I'll be leaving soon, as I have to keep a close eye on things while Redwood Outpost is being stored.
I know what you mean, Nelson. There's never enough manpower when you need it.
Oh, I didn't think you Ravens had problems in that department. After all, you have people like who managed to save Redwood Outpost from the Reavers almost single-handedly. If we just had 10 people like...
What I wouldn't give for that, too.
You really can't underestimate young folks these days, Caine.
Absolutely not. Well, maybe young, but they're a real asset around here.
Okay, it's getting late. I should get back to the outpost before sundown. It's a short walk, so no need to come with.
Stay in touch, then. Raven Shelter will always answer the call of our brothers and sisters.
Stay in touch, Caine. We'll meet again. Goodbye, Nelson. Caine, there's something you should know. The zombies over at Redwood Forest are evolving. They're stronger and more dangerous than any of the zombies we've seen in Redwood before.
Are you saying that Redwood has them, too? Things are progressing too fast.
Two? Have the Ravens noticed this already?
Yes. About a year ago, our scouts on the hill started noticing changes in the zombies there. They're not stagnant creatures. On the contrary, they seem to be constantly evolving. Our lab has been studying these changes in the hope that we can find a way to stop them happening. Dr. Sean is the one in charge of research. You might want to talk to him.
Of course.
Come with me. Try not to touch anything when you're inside the lab. Dr. Sean's a real stickler about this.
I'll be careful.
You came at just the right time. I was about to come to you. Look, we've reached a major breakthrough with our base study. I'm more or less certain that. Hold on, who's this?
This is the newest member of the Raven Squad. I think you should hear about changes in the zombies too, Doctor.
Some never before seen creatures have been spotted in Redwood Forest recently. I hear that you're studying something similar?
Ah, you're talking about the big scary ones, aren't you? We've managed to get our hands on some specimens. Small number, but enough for our purposes. I've named them ground smashers, because, you know, you're shakes with every step they take. My goodness, they.
So, about the changes?
This, of course, while we've already started on the characterization, we'll need more specimens to fully understand what's going on.
More specimens?
That's right, kiddo. More specimens. Just like in a mystery novel, you need all the clues you can get to build up your trail of evidence. And all I have now is a single fragment. Of course, I'll try to make sense of it anyway, since there's a lot that we still don't understand. Jamie, are you looking at the petri dish number two? It looks like it's running really hot. Jamie?
We'll leave you to it then, Doctor.
Yes, all right, Caine. Jamie, get your butt over here. I'll see you again then, Caine, and you too,
Goodbye, Dr. Sean.
The zombie research Dr. Sean in the lab running is top secret. You can't tell anyone about this. Ever.
Don't worry. I'll keep the Raven secrets no matter what.
We noticed zombies everywhere evolving about a year ago. Dr. Sean and his assistant set up this lab in the hopes of uncovering the reason for these changes and stopping them in their tracks. However, things have been going rather slowly due to the lack of resources for the research and data from before the disaster struck. Nevertheless, the lab is our best chance of solving the mystery of the outbreak, halting the disaster, and saving mankind. This has been the Raven's core mission all along.
I understand the responsibilities I bear as a member of the Raven Squad.
We believe that you will live up to your promise.
Everything will change for the better, Caine.
I hope so.